for the promised land. But the pace ended up, turned the kids to a monster man, monster clan. And show no remorse, cause that's what y'all taught me. On the mission to come up, trying to make $1 million. It's less than 20 years, ever since we've been here. We straight refugees, we're America's nightmare. It's less than 20 years, ever since we've been here. We straight refugees, we're America's nightmare.
In the States, you have so many things. So many things you can get your hands on. So many opportunities.
Growing up was kind of hard because we was different when we got to where we was in California. Well, actually, United States, period.
I grew up in Long Beach, California, and it was really prejudiced against Mexicans and Cambodian.
Just that I raised in the ghetto neighborhood, you know, they call it projects. And you know, there's all kind of races, Hispanics acting all hard, especially if you've been abused by other race.
People used to make fun of Cambodians, like we're gooks, they used to call us gooks, make fun of us, chinks, and
call us names, or, you know, purse snatching or necklace snatching, you know, picking on us, get tired, and can't stand it no more, just group up and made a game.
I mean, look, they're extorting us, they'll rob from us, they'll steal from us.
You know, because they're Laos or Thais, they're better than Khmer's, or Vietnamese, they're better than Khmer's. And
got beat up at the age of 12 and a half or something.
Like, they try to snatch our necklace, rob our mom and dad, our parents, you know, snatch their purses. We didn't like that.
So we all, like, group up, we all young, muscle, strong. We don't let these people come terrorize our folks.
My older cousins, they lived in the ghettos of San Diego, but I lived in the outskirts, so I wasn't really exposed to that. I mean, with school and all that stuff, I was like the only one, like one of the five Asian kids in that whole school, right? The only Khmer, and we were getting picked on and shit because we were different or whatever. And then I guess it was in me to just like stand up for that, like, you know, fuck off. You know what I mean? I'm no different than you are. Fuck. And I started getting in trouble. I started getting in trouble in school, defending myself, defending my friends at school. And then, you know, meeting up with my cousin, like, damn, these guys are cool. You know what I'm saying? These guys are cool. They have a group of guys who just kicks it all the time, and like whatever happens to the community, they're like protecting the Cambodian community in their own way, you know what I mean, with other people picking on the Cambodian community, just like how I was picked on in school by these white kids or black kids or whatever.
You know, it's not like we came illegal, you know what I mean? We came here as refugees, so we didn't come here without no fake passport, no fake green card, no nothing fake. Everything was all legit. Just what you mess up one time and they just snatch you, take you away from your family, you know?
Yeah, like we're legally there. I mean, I live in San Diego, right? So 15 minutes down the street is Mexico, and people just cross over the border all the time, illegally, you know? And they're fucking going around, you know, doing the things kids do too. To deport somebody that was there legally, that don't make sense at all. We were there as permanent residents. We just didn't get citizenship. That's it.
In the projects, mostly crack, cocaine, business, heroin. Where I live, a lot of heroin dealers, crackheads, and all that. So I catch the environment around there, where I raised that.
In Long Beach, with the Cambodian Hispanic gangs, you know, we're just on site, you know, to see each other, to shoot each other.
I got beat up by a Mexican. After that, I like feel like I had to get him back, or so I wouldn't hang out with the wrong crowd, and I can't.
Now why the fuck you wanna hate on me? We came from different places, but we all refugees. I'm a gangster, you're a gangster. So why the fuck you wanna hate on me? No, why the fuck you wanna hate on me? We came from different trenches, but we all refugees. I'm a gangster, you're a gangster. So why the fuck you wanna hate on me? Man, it's something hanging on us like everywhere I live. It's like all these players. Maybe playing by the book. Shit's off the hook. Why you keep
when we go there, we doing bad. People fuck you up at school, do all kind of crazy shit. You know, people get tired of that shit, man. And then that's not our blood, dog. That's not our culture. Yeah. Our culture is a warrior, man. We are warrior. We don't scare people. We respect people. That's why we don't do nothing bad. So now we get tired of that shit. There we go. We started. When we started, no, too dangerous. Gotta go back. I'm a general, okay? We are there. The street, okay? See, all these people die for my people, for Cambodian people, for us over there. You know, I'm an ex-gang member, okay? Not a gang, I'm an ex-gang member. Tiny Rascal gang. See, when I go to the state, they got one gang always fuck us up. They always do anything like that. Old people, you know? And then I don't know what to do. So we come up with the name, we start the name ourselves, TRG. We long with TRG now. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. Next thing you know, everybody start jumping and get more and more and more. And so some people don't recognize, some people don't know what the hell TRG beginning, who it is.
Some people really didn't have a chance in the United States because they were so hooked into the gangs, they were so, you know, living up the street life, you know.
First time I got it, I was locked up.